All right, I'm gonna try to talk on this one. This is odd because I don't have the dogs any longer, but because the average dog, the large dog, eats about one cow per year, it seems like, whoa, that's a lot of cow. And so you have them maybe the 14 or 15 years on the average, lucky persons, and they are eating 15 cows in the lifetime. So then we needn't support having so many of the large dogs. They need to be more a luxury item of just a few available. They can't be for everyone. They are too disruptive in planetary politics of ecology. I hate to say it, but yeah, you look at the dog food, it's a 20% of protein. And it can be the cow, it can be also the chicken. The chickens also are taking the same space planetary-wise because they still have to grow the corn, they still have to grow the wheat for henny penny, and all of this is going on, and all of this is going on. And the oyster shells are needed, and all of these things are needed extra, added into the food supply, and all of these are disruptors from instead of just growing vegetables and eating them, it's an entire field is needed specifically for corn and wheat, and then onto the space for the chickens, and then the politics of yes, they have to be free, they cannot be all of the time inside indoors locked into hideous cages. So it doesn't matter the 20% if it's the chicken, if it is the beef. That particular protein item, simple changes, turning that into the pulses or turning it into what's the other one? Putting this heavy amino acid stinging nettle out there as a major protein that could be added into the dog foods. All of these, you know, in there. And that would be a wonder to make the vegetarian dog foods, and that would be a great new business to become a new capitalism for someone who wants to do this. But it's getting the persons away from the how many chickens a year are they equivocated to the one cow for the large dog. I'm not sure. It's possible. Gosh, I imagine a chicken in the same sizeery. If you just take that picture of the cow and you plant it with the chickens all around it, I imagine it's the same amount of space utilization also with the food take, the pastures. So how do we switch the dogs away? Because it's not inherently what they're supposed to be eating. You know, they are really very much, they can be more and more omnivore, more and more omnivore, more and more vegetarian. But originally they're carnivore. And the only omnivore item there is the gullet, of the intestine, captured from the stomach areas of the deers and the happy little enchantlings. eating those roughages there after the digestive process has gone through. So, So that's the big hassle right now is downsizing the amount of large dogs, as much as we love them and much as we want them for protection. We have to go another way. And not have that luxury. Everybody has a large dog, and I know we're out there. Well, let's sell the domestic thing to like Indonesia, so they stop eating the dogs. Let's sell them as glamour breeds. But as soon as you start the glamour breed syndrome needs to eat the chickens and the beef. And that becomes chickens and beef from where? Probably from right here in France, is sold to Indonesia to feed the glamour breeds in Indonesia now. So it has become such a ridiculous, and then they're yelling, no free trade, no free trade. And you wonder why those kids were yelling, you know, you wonder. All right, so what's going on? Back to, my gosh, who gets the large dogs? Who gets the large dogs? It's really what it comes down to. Who gets them? We have to stop having them in the pet stores. You can have your little tin muffin wawas, yip yaps, all you want. They're not really a harm. But yeah, they need a huge amount of food. As soon as they start hitting 75 pounds, 85 pounds, 95, 105, they need a huge amount of food. So, like I said, you know, stopping off at the Mickey D's, you know, ordering like 7 or 10 of those and pretty much for the dogs. So, what was I saying on? How do we take, but I really want to have the largest animal. I want to have the large Newfoundland or a giant's great Bernard. And yeah, I mean, right now we are still with the animal overflows. We still have animal overflows in those particular, just go pick a dog up, you know. It's the remake right now. We can't be remaking them. We already have a supply. We already have a surplus. And people get tired of dogs quite quickly. And when that goes on, well, you have to take the older dogs. You have to take the medium-aged dogs. You have to take the one that was the puppy that was not trained properly. You have to take those and go at it and train them when they're 3 years old. You just have to do those things. We cannot be going after luxury puppies any longer. Large dogs. Samoyeds. Any of the huskies. Unless you're going to be out there praying for the roadkill and going to go slop up a porcupine on occasion, I don't think you want to do that as a food source regenerative. I don't think so. That's not really cool. I don't have any shock factor to give you today, aside from, doesn't matter if it's chicken or the beef, they're still using the pastures. All right. And yeah, less large dogs. Gosh dang it, they are beautiful, and they are beautiful for sure, but what a luxury that we've overmade. Alaskan Malamutes, and oh my gosh, yeah.